Hi, this is Jason from the QuickBooks team. In QuickBooks Desktop, you use bills to track how much you owe to vendors and how long you have to pay the balance. You enter a bill if your vendor gives you time to pay, and you want to track how much you owe them until you're ready to pay the balance. Let's talk about how to enter bills, check your balance with a vendor, and pay outstanding bills. When you receive a new bill from a vendor, select Enter Bills. First, let's take a tour of the bill window. From the ribbon, you can save or print a bill. You can also include attachments, such as the original copy of the bill. Bills collect specific information about your business purchases, who you owe money to, when you owe them, how much you owe, and what you pay for. QuickBooks collects this information to run reports later. Start with who you owe. Select Add New to set up a new vendor, or select the vendor's name from the list if you've already set them up. If a subcontractor sends you a bill, you enter their name from the vendor's list as well. If you've already entered a purchase order, QuickBooks asks if you want to use the purchase order to fill out the bill. Once you select the vendor, QuickBooks populates the bill with their info, such as their address and the set payment terms you have with them. The terms help QuickBooks calculate the due date. Some vendors may offer early pay discounts as part of your terms. For example, your vendor offers a 2% discount if you pay within the first 10 days you receive the bill. QuickBooks displays the date you need to pay by to receive the discount. If you pay before the discount date, QuickBooks also calculates the appropriate discount amount when you pay for it. Enter the bill number, which is usually at the top of your bill. This helps you avoid recording the same bill twice, because QuickBooks will warn you if you enter the same bill number again for this vendor. Now you record what your vendor charges you for. First, if you purchase inventory, choose your inventory item from the list in the Items tab and fill in the appropriate quantity. Otherwise, select the account that best describes your purchase from the vendor. Then enter how much you owe your vendor. You may need multiple lines to best describe your purchase. Select each account and enter the amount of the bill that applies to that account. If you want to track your costs for a specific customer or job on reports, select the customer or job for each line of the bill. If you plan to invoice your customers for these costs, check the billable box. This helps you add the costs to a customer's invoice later on. Once you save the bill, QuickBooks increases your balance with the vendor. Select Vendors to see who you owe and how much you owe them. You see the balance you have with the vendor. Select the vendor's name to see more details about your balance, such as bills and any payments you make. To see a report of which bills you need to pay, select Reports, Vendors and Payables, Unpaid Bills. You see all the unpaid bills and applied credits by vendor. You can use this report to review your own bills. Let's pay some bills now. Select Pay Bills. Select the bills you'd like to pay. You can select multiple bills from different vendors, and QuickBooks will create a separate check for each one. If you select multiple bills for the same vendor, QuickBooks combines the bills onto one payment. If you only pay a portion of the bill, just enter the amount you want to pay instead. You can also apply any early pay discounts or use any credits you may have with the vendor. If you pay the bill with a credit card, you can select the credit card method. For all other types of payment, including automatic bank withdrawals or online payments with your debit card, select Check. Select To Be Printed if you need to print the checks to send to the vendor. Otherwise, select Assign Check Number to record handwritten checks or online payments. Select Pay Selected Bills. If you choose to assign check numbers, enter the handwritten check numbers or other payment description, like debit or ACH. You see a summary of which bills you just paid. If you chose to print the checks later, select File, Print Forms, Checks, and you'll see them listed with any other checks you've marked to print later. Now when you run the unpaid bills report again, QuickBooks no longer lists the bills you just paid, and you see which bills are still outstanding. You're ready to enter and pay bills in QuickBooks Desktop.